If you're wondering what a bus is doing with a pantograph, you'll have to wait a little. I think the Vicinal still actually operates this service. Back on that bus again, which is much like any other bus on the road, although it does seem to be particularly underpowered on the hills. And this is coming to Rochefort, heading back towards Chemelle, which is the railway station. And along here somewhere it'll get back on its guided track. A bit like a slot car, in fact. Oui. Très cher.
Très cher.
Mm. Mais un bon repas. There was the guide wheel, which makes quite a rumble. I don't think you can compare with Adelaide. Still on that straight bit, but we're our speed's pretty low. About 45. This section of track for the rubber tyres are steel and a bit narrower. Speed's dropping down to about 30 now. I really think it's just a toy. Also suspect they've taken over an old railway line which possibly could have been closed a long time ago. We went around some very tight curves just here somewhere near the depot. They're a bit sensitive about the depot too. That's a point blade, which is a bit like a stub-nose point. From here it appears as though every axle's guided. I suppose it really would have to be for the sharp curves and to keep it on the track. Can't see any guidance there. It might be just behind the tyre. It'll be here for a while and then it goes to the station. It's obvious that every wheel turns, rotates. Unfortunately, he dropped the pando before he took off. Now. I think it's going to pour in a minute. Although it looks double-ended, the back end's purely engine with just a little windscreen for a video camera. Not sure whether it's running diesel, electric, or just plain diesel at this stage.